1988, Noam Chomsky co-authored a book with Edward Herman called Manufacturing Consent. It blasted apart the notion that media acts as a check on political powers. Media operate through five filters. The first has to do with ownership. Mass media firms are big corporations. Often, they're part of even bigger conglomerates. Their end game, profit. And so it's in their interests to push for whatever guarantees that profit. Critical journalism takes second place to the needs and interests of the corporation. The second filter exposes the real role of advertising. Media costs a lot more than consumers will ever pay. So who fills the gap? Advertisers. And what are the advertisers paying for? Audiences. And so it isn't so much that the media are selling you a product, their output. They're also selling advertisers a product, you. How does the establishment manage the media? That's the third filter.
Yeah.
Journalism cannot be a check on power because the very system encourages complicity.
Yeah.
Governments, corporations, big institutions know how to play the media game. They know how to influence the news narrative. They feed media scoops, official accounts, interviews with the experts. They make themselves crucial to the process of journalism. So those in power and those who report on them are in bed with each other. If you want to challenge power, you'll be pushed to the margins. Your name won't be down. You won't be getting in. You've lost your access. You've lost the story. When the media, journalists, whistleblowers, sources, stray away from the consensus, they get flat. That's the fourth filter. When the story is inconvenient for the powers that be, you'll see the flack machine in action, discrediting sources, trashing stories, and diverting the conversation. To manufacture consent, you need an enemy, a target. That common enemy is the fifth filter. Communism, terrorists, immigrants, a common enemy. A boogeyman to fear helps corral public opinion. Five filters, one big media theory. Consent is being manufactured all around you, all the time.
If there is more dissidence now than you can remember, why do you go on to write that the people feel isolated?
Because I think much of the general population recognizes that the organized institutions do not reflect their concerns and interests and needs. They do not feel that they participate meaningfully in the political system. They do not feel that the media are telling them the truth or even reflect their concerns. They go outside of the organized institutions to act.
We see more and more of our elected leaders know less and less of what they're doing.
Yeah.
If this medium does that.
Very striking. In fact, the presidential elections have been almost removed from the point where the public even takes them seriously as involving a matter of choice.
So what do you think about what goes on in the White House?
It's kept too private, I think.
Yeah, they should come out.
I know.
To people.
Yeah.
Who should talk to the people?
George Bush.
Well, it means that the political system increasingly functions without public input. It means to an increasing extent, not only do people not ratify decisions presented to them, but they don't even take the trouble of ratifying them. They assume that the decisions are going on independently of what they may do in the polling booth.
Ratification would be what?
Well, ratification would mean a system in which there are two positions presented to me, the voter. I go into the polling booth and I push one or another button depending on which of those positions I want. That's a very limited form of democracy. Really meaningful democracy would mean that I play a role in forming those decisions and creating those positions. And that would be real democracy.
That's not
we're very far from that. But we're even departing from the point where there is ratification. When you have stage-managed elections, with the public relations industry determining what words come out of people's mouth, candidates decide what to say on the basis of tests that determine what the effect will be across the population. Somehow people don't see how profoundly contemptuous that is of democracy.